from News 8 WMTW-TV. This is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
And I'm Erin O'Valley. Today, Governor Paula Page will sign a bill to reform business and environmental regulations. News 8's Dave Guthrow has more on the story from Portland's Monument Square.
Well, last week, the Maine Senate unanimously voted to pass LD1, which is a bill that aims to help business owners in Maine exist by taking out some of the regulations. Some of the businesses here in Monument Square in Portland certainly fall into that category. Governor LePage submitted the bill based on feedback he received from business owners during the statewide red tape removal meetings. This bill includes a dozen regulatory changes, including the creation of a business intermediary that would resolve problems between businesses and the state, a special advocate within the office of the secretary area state, eliminating licensing, some of the licensing and paperwork involved with inspections to cut back on paperwork, and also the Board of Environmental Protection would lose three members and its permitting process would be streamlined. Now, some of the controversial pieces of the bill have been taken out and given to other committees for further review, but we do understand that the governor does plan to sign this bill into law around noon today, and we'll have full coverage of that on our website, WMTW.com, as well as tonight on News 8 at 6. For now in Portland, Dave Guthrow for News 8.
From Wall Street to Main Street, News 8's Project Economy is our commitment to coverage beyond the headlines. As we report in the past, Town of Cape Elizabeth continues to look for ways to generate more revenue at Fort Williams Park. Officials say it's needed to meet growing capital expenses and maintenance costs at the park. Tonight, the Town Council will take up recommendations on fees for tour buses and trolleys that enter the park. A report from the Fort Williams Advisory Commission recommended tour buses be charged $40 per visit, while trolley companies should pay a seasonal fee of $1,500 for each trolley. Commission also recommended not charging camp and recreation program buses.
Jury selection is set to start this morning in Cumberland County Court for a Westbrook man facing assault charges. Justin DiGaetano faces charges of aggravated assault with a deadly weapon and attempted elevated aggravated assault. Police say that back in November, during a confrontation with another man, DiGaetano pulled out a gun and hit the victim over the head and in the face. Police say the victim managed to grab the gun and get away.
State police have identified the man whose body was found in an apartment Saturday morning in Augusta. Maine State Police spokesman Steve McConslin says 46-year-old David Cox was reported dead just before dawn. Now, he lives in an apartment on 12 Green Street with the male roommate. McConslin says police hope to learn the cause of the death through an autopsy. Make sure to stay with News 8 and WMTW.com for the latest information as this story develops.
Lewiston police are searching for a suspect they say robbed a Sam's Italian Foods restaurant yesterday morning. It all happened at the 268 Main Street location just after 11 o'clock. Officers say that a man demanded money from a clerk working behind a register but did not show a weapon. Police are not saying how much money was actually stolen. Fortunately, nobody was injured. And anyone with information on this is asked to call the Lewiston police. And thanks for tuning in to this News 8 Now update. I'm Erin O'Valley.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. We'll bring the latest forecast and sports highlights in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.